subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 9th of December. Tri-service probe ordered into Indian Defence Chief's chopper crash, black box recovered. Pakistan detects first suspected case of Omicron variant. An Afghan Olympic committee urges athletes who fled Taliban rule to return home. And now for all the details. India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Thursday told the Parliament that a tri-service inquiry will be conducted into the helicopter crash incident a day earlier that resulted in the death of the country's first Chief of Defence Staff Bipin Rawat, his wife and 11 other personnel. He said the remains of all the deceased would be brought to New Delhi and cremated with full military honours. Meanwhile, on Thursday, black box of the chopper was also recovered that would provide crucial data on the chain of events before the crash in southern Tamil Nadu state.
India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Thursday said that a tri-service inquiry will be conducted into the helicopter crash incident that resulted in the death of the country's first Chief of Defence Staff, Bipin Rawat, his wife and 11 other personnel. In a brief statement in the Parliament, Defence Minister Singh said, the Mi-17 V-5 helicopter carrying CDS Rawat lost contact with the airbase 7 minutes before it was scheduled to land at a hillside military area at 12:15 p.m. in southern Tamil Nadu state. The defence minister said investigation into the crash has already begun. He informed the remains of all the deceased would be brought to New Delhi and cremated with full military honours. While all efforts are being made to save the lone survivor of the crash, Air Force Group Captain Varun Singh, who is on life support at a military hospital.
Defence staff ka antim sanskar full military honours ke saath kiya jayega. और अन्य सभी मिलिट्री पर्सनल का अंतिम संस्कार भी एप्रोप्रिएट मिलिट्री ऑनर के साथ किया जाएगा।
Meanwhile, on Thursday morning, the black box of the chopper was recovered from the crash site in Tamil Nadu's Kunur. The black box would provide crucial data on the chain of events leading to the Wednesday's tragedy. 63-year-old Rawat was appointed as India's first Chief of Defence Staff by Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government in late 2019. The position was set up with the aim of integrating the Army, Navy and the Air Force.
Indian farmers called off their year-long agitation on Thursday after the government conceded to a clutch of their pending demands, including assurances to consider guaranteed prices for all produce. The move comes after the government last month rolled back 3 farm laws, a key demand of the protesting farmers. The farmers will start vacating the protest sites from December 11, their leaders said.
Indian farmers called off the long-running protest on Thursday after the government conceded to a clutch of demands, including assurances to consider guaranteed prices for all produce, not just rice and wheat. The farmers will start vacating the protest sites from December 11, their leaders said. Tens of thousands of farmers have staged more than a year of protests to persuade Prime Minister Narendra Modi to repeal 3 agriculture laws passed in September 2020. In a surprise move, Prime Minister Modi's government rolled them back last month. Despite the government's clampdown, farmers continued to press for other demands to be met, such as minimum support prices for all produce and taking back legal cases filed against protesters.
हर महीने इसकी समीक्षा करते रहेंगे 15 जनवरी को फिर एसडीएम की मीटिंग बनाई है अगर सरकार अपने वादों से दाएं बाएं हिलती है तो फिर हम
Agriculture, which accounts for nearly 15% of India's $2.7 trillion economy, is the livelihood of more than half its population of 1.3 billion.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan has reported its first suspected case of the new COVID-19 variant Omicron in a woman in Karachi city. Health Minister of Sindh Province, Dr. Azra Pechuho, in a video statement released on Thursday, said a genomic study is being conducted which will confirm the exact variant, but the way the virus is behaving, it seems likely that it is the Omicron variant. The minister urged citizens to get vaccinated at the earliest. The provincial health department disclosed that the 57-year-old unvaccinated patient is currently isolating at home and efforts are underway to conduct contact tracing. Pakistan had earlier this month approved booster shots for healthcare workers and those above the age of 50 amid the Omicron scare. It had also tightened rules on inbound flights, largely banning entry from several at-risk South African nations. More on news from Pakistan. Traders and businessmen in Pakistan have expressed anger over rising inflation and unjust taxation policies as they struggle with the economic fallout from the COVID-19 pandemic. Chairman of Traders Association in Financial Capital Karachi slammed Prime Minister Imran Khan's government for failing to come up with progressive planning to tackle the crisis.
Traders and businessmen in Pakistan have lamented they are struggling with economic fallout from the COVID-19 pandemic, rising inflation and unjust tax policies of the government, and fear the worst for the future. According to reports, Pakistan's rupee hit a record low on Wednesday, closing at 177.43 against the US dollar on the back of a rising trade deficit. Pakistan's rupee has lost 12.6% of its value since July 1st, the start of the country's fiscal year. Sheikh Habib, chairman of a traders association in Karachi, slammed Prime Minister Imran Khan's government and said it is not making any progressive plans to tackle inflation that is hitting the country's poor and middle classes really hard.
Mehngai ka jo silab hai, usne pehle hi is mulk ka diwaliya nikal diya hai. और मैं ये समझ रहा हूँ कि जिस तरह की पॉलिसीज हुकूमत वक्त की है, मैं ये समझ रहा हूँ कि मुल्क हमारा जो है खुदा ना खास्ता डिफॉल्ट की तरफ जा रहा है, इसलिए कि इनकी कोई प्लानिंग नज़र नहीं आ रही है.
Meanwhile, according to a recent nationwide perceptions survey conducted by the Transparency International, 92.9% Pakistanis consider inflation and price hike to be the highest in the current PTI government. This coincides with 85.9% Pakistanis who say their income levels have rather squeezed and decreased over the last 3 years.
In news from Afghanistan, many athletes and sportspersons, mainly women, have left Afghanistan since the Taliban takeover in August. Afghanistan's National Olympic Committee acting president has called on athletes who had fled the country since the takeover to return home, saying those who craved recognition and a better life in other countries would never have their wish fulfilled. Afghanistan's National Olympic Committee acting president on Wednesday called on athletes who had fled the country after the Taliban takeover to return home. Nazar Mohammad Motmain made the comments during a ceremony in Kabul honoring Afghan players who won medals for Afghanistan over the last 20 years and earned global recognition for their country. Around 200 players were honored by the Afghan National Olympic Committee and the Department of Sports for representing Afghanistan in various sports.
زموش سره یو ځای ناست وي د قهرمانانو مډال لرونکو او ورزشکارانو عزت په خپل وطن کې ده په خپل کلی کې ده په خپل ولسوالۍ کې ده په خپل ولایت او په افغانستان کې ده هغه څوک چې غواړي چې بهر ته ولاړ شي او هلته به عزت ولري هلته به ښه ژوند ولري باور وکړي تر مرګه به هم دغه غرمه.
Athlete Ramin Mohammadi also urged the Taliban government to support Afghan athletes. Many athletes and sportspersons, mainly women, have left Afghanistan since the Taliban takeover in August. They were helped by international athletic representatives and sporting bodies, including the IOC and FIFA. A women's youth soccer team from Afghanistan arrived in the United Kingdom on November 18, months after the Taliban took control of their country. Earlier this year, Australia evacuated more than 50 female Afghan athletes and their dependents after lobbying by prominent figures from the sporting world, while several players from Afghanistan's national female youth soccer squad were granted asylum in Portugal. Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. The body of Sri Lankan factory manager Priyanta, who was killed in a brutal mob attack in Pakistan after being accused of blasphemy, was laid to rest on Wednesday in his home country. Priyanta's family members said they are still struggling to make sense of the inhumanity of the killing.
The remains of Sri Lankan factory manager Priyanta Kumara, who was killed in a shocking and deadly mob attack in Pakistan after being accused of blasphemy, were laid to rest on Wednesday in Sri Lanka. A mob of factory employees in Pakistan's Punjab province tortured and burned Priyanta Kumara on December 3. The 48-year-old factory manager is survived by his wife and two sons. His remains were flown to Sri Lanka on Monday and kept at his home in Gampaha district. People took part in a Buddhist funeral ceremony before family members of Kumara carried his casket to the local cemetery.
I am here that, okay, the incident what was happened, that we don't know how to justify that. And it is a disaster. And then what we face and what we are facing is unable to explain. That is speechless. We have that, okay, lot of emotions, lot of sadness. And then truly we lost our brother, and which we cannot take back.
The Sri Lankan government earlier on Tuesday approved an ex gratia of nearly $12,500 to the kin of Priyanta and has also asked Pakistan to pay compensation. Pakistani police has said they have arrested over 130 people in connection with the killing. Allegations of blasphemy have often triggered several mob attacks in Pakistan, where blasphemy carries a possible death penalty.
At the International Conference on Nepal's Reconstruction 2021 this week, Nepali officials reported substantial progress in the reconstruction efforts following the devastating earthquakes in 2015, as donors and development partners pledged more support to the South Asian country.
Nepali officials on Wednesday reported substantial progress in the reconstruction efforts following the devastating earthquakes in 2015, as donors and development partners pledged more support to the South Asian country. Addressing the opening ceremony of the International Conference on Nepal's Reconstruction 2021, Nepali President Bidya Devi Bhandari spoke of the remarkable progress in rebuilding over 700,000 individual houses and most of the damaged schools, health institutions and heritage sites.
Nepali jantalai ukta pidabata bahira nikalna antarashtriya samudayale khula bidhai ka sath hamilai karib 4.5 arba dollar ko vittiya ebam anya pravidhik sahayog upalabdha garaune प्रतिबद्धता व्यक्त गर्यो। अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय समुदायबाट प्रतिबद्धता अनुसारको अधिकांश सहयोग प्राप्त भइरहेको सुन्दा मलाई अत्यन्तै खुसी लागेको छ।
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, addressing the conference via video message, said that New Delhi has substantially fulfilled its commitments made for reconstruction of sectors identified by the Nepali government as the nation builds back from the devastation caused by 2015 earthquake.
Over the last 5 years and more, India has substantially fulfilled our commitment under various priority sectors identified by the government of Nepal. I take this opportunity to share we have completed construction of 50,000 owner-driven houses in Gorkha and Nuwakot district under Indian assistance.
The projects in remaining sectors of health, education and culture are also under progress, Indian Foreign Minister said. In 2015, Nepal suffered two high-magnitude earthquakes that left around 9,000 people dead and more than 22,000 injured. The disaster damaged more than 800,000 houses, incurring a total loss of $7 billion. The three-day conference that began on Tuesday was organized by the Nepali government to share the experience and progress of post-earthquake reconstruction with the international community.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.